I am going to be talking about the codes and conventions of a successful documentary. There are six types of documentaries, including fully narrated, fly on the wall, mixed, self-reflective, docudrama, and docusoap. A fully narrated documentary has a voiceover to help the audience gain a better understanding of the documentary shown. This can also be known as the voice of God. It goes along and is based on the visuals shown. A fly on the wall documentary has no commentary. It's not staged, it's shown as actuality and has no interviews. This is a fully observational documentary. A mixed documentary includes a combination of interviews, observational footage and narration. It can also include archive footage, which is footage which hasn't been filmed by the documentary filmers themselves. A self-reflective documentary is when the filmmaker is present. They have total acknowledgement of the camera. An example of this is Bear Grylls' Born Survivor. A docudrama documentary is usually a reconstructed piece of history. They are mainly factual, and the documentary drama isn't shown as reality, hence the word drama. Lastly, a docu-soap is a documentary of people in a particular occupation or location of a period of time. This is shown as real footage and real people. Next, I'm going to talk about the narrative structure. This is the way a documentary is structured out. Firstly, it could be open or closed. Open doesn't give a definitive ending, and closed has a definitive ending. Single-stranded is when there is one storyline within the documentary. Multi-stranded has more than one storyline. An example of this is a soap. If a documentary is linear, this means it is chronological order, whereas if it was non-linear, this could include flashbacks, and it could go forwards into time. This means that it isn't in a chronological order. Lastly, a documentary could be circular or non-circular. Circular is when the documentary ends, has the same ending and start. Cam work is very important when it comes to documentaries, especially in interviews. A code and convention is called the rule of thirds. This is when in an interview, the position of the person is on a side, either left or right, with the space to talk into in the middle of the screen. Many observational footage is usually a handheld camera, so the cameramen can move around to get all the footage they can and see all surroundings. Mise-en-scene is very important in observational footage. All the locations are relevant to the themes within a documentary. Also, the lighting is key. High key lighting is used to look natural. Also, natural lighting is used when in interviews to make the documentary look realistic. When it comes to sound in a documentary, it can have a variety of sounds such as soundtrack, dialogue, voiceover, incidental music, and archive sound. Editing is kept simple in documentaries. It is known commonly for straight cuts to happen. This is so the audience is always entertained. Cutaways are also used so the audience can see every bit of a documentary, even if the camera isn't pointing onto the person that is directly talking into the camera. Archive footage is important in some documentaries. They are used to show history. Lastly, graphics are used. This is text on the screen that is factual information. This could include the title screen, credits, name and occupation of an interviewee, and also social media.